And another way to avoid burnout, as you mentioned, you've got to boost your energy levels.
Yes.
That might be doing something fun, or it might be looking at natural health ways to do it. So we've got Bryce Wylde here to help us out, everybody. Things that we could talk about, but let's start with caffeine.
Yeah, well, we can't have a conversation about energy without having a conversation about caffeine, right?
Mm-hmm.
Why do people drink coffee and take energy shots and caffeinated beverages to boost energy, right? But honestly, wrong. Why wrong? Because caffeine doesn't equal energy. It's fake energy.
It's fake energy.
It tricks your cells into believing it's getting energy. It's really just epinephrine, actually.
Okay.
And your kidneys have these little adrenal glands that sit on top of them, and they make epinephrine or adrenaline. You know this feeling when you get adrenalized, fight or flight?
Yes.
Caffeine is the same molecule. It just makes more of this epinephrine. In fact, when we drink too much coffee and caffeinated beverages, we are trending toward burnout. Right?
Okay.
So fake energy. So we're going to talk about our real forms of energy. If you don't mind, I will bring you back just briefly to biology class, 11th grade.
Let's go back to biology.
Do you mind? Let's do biology class.
I like this. I love this fake energy. I just want to mention.
And you know, so I purposely did not have my coffee this morning, my organic coffee.
You didn't?
Just for the show. I wanted to see like
How are you doing right now?
I'll let you know later. No, really, I enjoy it, but too much. So 400 milligrams and lower, studies show, is relatively safe, but too much is going to cause heart palpitations, anxiety, restlessness, insomnia. Kids are dying from this in clubs and on top of drinking alcohol and other drugs.
Totally.
But combining caffeine can be deadly. Too much of it anyway. So the cell. This is a human cell.
Yeah.
And we have trillions of them. We're made of trillions of them. But they all contain one important thing I want to point out. Mm-hmm. This little red peanut-shaped like thing.
Yeah.
Remember this? The term is mitochondria.
Oh, yes.
Remember the mitochondria?
It's all coming back.
This is what makes ATP, which is the currency of energy. Energy in your body.
Okay.
Caffeine cannot provide that to you. Micronutrient-rich foods and certain lifestyle practices can. So what we're really going to focus on as an underlying theme is what can we do to increase mitochondrial function, ATP.
Real energy.
In fact, before we even make this green shake, tons of micronutrients, it's real simple.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I start my morning off with a contrast shower. Right?
Oh, you do the cold, hot?
So hot, cold, hot,
hot cold.
So it starts with hot, and you just relax as long as you want, but freezing cold as up to a minute, and then back to hot.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, the second time you do the cold, it's like nothing. But boy, do you wake up out of there invigorated and with a lot more energy, okay? So this is real simple.
I'm never going to do that.
You're not going to do that? But you know what?
Dr. Joey does that, and she says she hates it every single morning,
but she does it every single morning
because it works.
It's like exercise. It's like, you know, you don't like doing the major exercise, but once you've done it, you can't not do
you
it again.
You just feel
you
good.
You have to, right.
Okay.
Simple. A cup of spinach, one banana. I'm going to get you to add some simple organic vanilla protein powder in there. And that goes. And I'm going to one-up the spinach by adding spirulina. Micronutrient-packed, you know, all the stuff that your ATP want and love.
Okay.
And up that goes to high speed. And I'll let you, as typically, be the taste tester. You need nothing more, folks, than a little banana to sweeten this. You don't need extra sweeteners, okay?
And I'll I should have blended it more.
You're my taste tester, right? So we're going to start off our morning with that on top of maybe a couple of eggs.
Let me smell it first. It's good.
It's a green monster drink. Nothing less than that. Not bad, right? You want to blend it a little higher.
I'm still chewing the spinach. This actually doesn't taste bad at all.
It looks atrocious, but it tastes really good.
If you are
really craving caffeine and you can't live without it and you get the migraine headaches and the withdrawal symptoms, you may be low in vitamin B12.
Okay.
So have your doctor check that. This is a liquid form. It goes under your tongue. And you let that sit there for a couple of seconds.
Actually.
Yummy, right? Satisfy your B12 levels. If you can't kick the caffeine, you can't kick the coffee, tyrosine. It's an amino acid that can really help you along, minimize the side effects, and give you a little bit of what you're missing from caffeine. Okay?
Tyrosine, everyone, because I'm the one that gets the tweets when they're like, what did Bryce say about
the amino
acid? Tyrosine, that's going to be very popular.
It'll help you out. 600 milligrams a day in capsule form. You swallow it back. It'll really help you kick the hat. Listen, I'm a fan of the right type of coffee. We'll talk about that later on in the show. What's the right type and why do you want the right type?
Yeah.
These don't do it for me, but if you want to go caffeine-free, for some people, they're just taking too much in, so have that first cup of coffee and then go to the alternatives.
Right.
This is really just a grain, fermented, roasted grain alternative. So for the flavor, the warmth, the satisfaction at your desk side. Yeah, I'm with you on that.
Yeah, I'm with you. What is it?
It's just a roasted barley.
It's roasted barley.
Yeah, roasted
grain. It's not bad.
Yeah, I'm more of a fan of this one coming out. So there's a whole variety of these guys. They're instants. You know, make sure you get the organics. There's chugga. This is a mushroom and a lot of immune benefits to chaga mushroom.
Okay.
So it's kind of all sort of that same gnarly taste to it. This is one of my favorites as an alternative. Ginger has so many benefits, anti-inflammatory benefits.
So
this one here
is
just blended with honey already. So you pour some hot water.
It looks like quinoa in a drink.
It looks like bee pollen to me, but it's just
or
ginger
bee pollen,
crystals.
Yes.
It's just ginger crystals.
Okay.
So that one's quite tasty.
Have I mentioned I hate ginger?
I love ginger. It's got a bite, right?
That's got bite.
Yeah, that's got bite.
Actually, this is better than eating ginger.
Yeah, no.
This tastes good, actually.
Whether it's for a cold, but I mean, we're talking alternatives to caffeine.
Yeah.
This will simply really boost your energy levels.
Okay.
Now, just quick caution. You will find a lot of alternatives on the market that are simply natural.
Mm-hmm.
They may even be organic, but these are alternatives to coffee and insofar as boosting energy. But guess what?
Whether it's chocolate over here.
Right, chocolate has caffeine in it, in fact.
Mm-hmm.
But see, whether this is a drink that contains yerba mate, which is a type of tea leaf, or guarana bean, or kola nut. We'll have these lists on the website, okay?
Yeah, this is good too.
Cityline.tv, yeah, that's really delicious, right?
Yeah, it's very good.
But here's the bottom line. These are natural, but they've got caffeine in them.
Oh.
And yet they don't list caffeine on the label. So yerba mate, kola nut, well, because they're naturally caffeine.
Okay.
So it's a real gray zone.
Okay,
just be careful.
For you?
They are okay for you,
okay.
But in limitation. So some of these will have half of the amount of an average cup of coffee, which is 100 milligrams.
Yes.
Some of these will have 50 milligrams.
Okay, so make sure you read the labels.
Absolutely. So
what
just
else you got?
Pass my cell over here. So we're going to come back to, so boosting your ATP, boosting the mitochondrial function, what that's going to do for you, by the way, is beyond just living longer and healthier, improving health span, will give you energy now, but real, true energy.
Yes.
Right? And so here are my favorites. Ashwagandha.
Okay.
PQQ, which is kind of like coenzyme Q10. You've heard of that before?
Yes.
Well, PQQ actually makes more mitochondria for you. So some people's issue is not just fueling mitochondria, but making more of them within the cell, which is possible.
Okay.
This is one of my favorites, Dr. Brenner out of Iowa University, the discovery. It's a type of vitamin B3 called nicotinamide riboside. Okay, so forget
It's
a long one. Niagen will literally boost NAD, which boosts ATP. So athletes, weekend warriors, desk side jockeys. I mean, sitting is the new smoking.
For sure.
Right? Niagen. Look into that. TrueNiagen.com. Okay?
All right.
Now, I love the Apple Watch. Why? Because it actually reminds me to stand. Just
does it
standing.
Say that?
Literally, it says time
get
to stand.
Up.
Yeah. So sitting is the new smoking. Get up, move at work if you can, or you're on the phone, or you're doing something you could otherwise be standing or walking for.
Yes, walk
Please
around.
Do it. It'll boost energy. And by the way, I don't know about you, but playing music in the car, whether it's on the way to work or it's at work, just to get that energy boost, for me, it's AC/DC.
Oh,
I don't know about you.
Listen, music all the time, all the way.
Yeah.
That's
Great
how
way.
I get through my runs. I look forward to listening to my playlist. I love
it. I can't run without music.
Me
I don't know,
neither.
But I cannot run
me
without
neither.
Music. This is a little ginseng shot. Now, ginseng is another really wonderful adaptogen. That means it helps our bodies adapt better.
Yeah.
In traditional Chinese medicine, those adrenal glands I talked about earlier.
Okay.
So this is a little shot of ginseng to your health. What do you think of that flavor?
I like a little, I like the little straw is what I like.
It's cute, right?
But yeah, this is
little ginseng shot, amazing for energy, natural.
Yeah.
Folks, don't forget to take a nap here and there if you really need
it. Go to sleep.
That will help. Well, not just sleep overnight, but taking a 10 to 15 minute tops trucker nap, which won't interrupt your night sleep.
Mm-hmm.
So just enough to regenerate and rejuvenate. Sometimes you're tired and yawning. It doesn't mean reach for caffeine to stimulate you. It means you're you need to take a nap.
That's right.
And lastly, wake up with blue light. You can find these relatively inexpensively at your local health food store.
Okay.
Blue and red light spectrum, but if you have blue light, when you first wake up in the morning, so desk side, and you read the headline news for 10 minutes or your smartphone, that will actually induce serotonin and get you started on a higher energy note than the regular incandescents that are around your house.
Nice. Okay, we have
blue
no
light.
Excuse to be low energy anymore.
Yes.
That was amazing.
Yes.
Thank you.